A very good morning to all of you. I welcome all of you for this INBIX 2020, starting from today, December 4th to 5th. And the theme of this year's conference is Recent Advances in Computational Biology for Codifying Biodiversity into One Health Approach. Biodiversity, climate change, One Health, and zoonotic diseases are some of the points that we would like to discuss during the next 2 days of this conference. And I am very happy and privileged to be a part of this BioClues organization, which is probably one of the largest organizations in India trying to cater to bioinformatics students, scientists, and bioinformatics fraternity. And the way in which the organization evolved is amazing. When in 2005, Dr. Prashant Suravachula, known as Prash, and Pritish Varadwaj have started, it has completed 15 years and it has many, many different experiences and journeys. And one of the important conferences is this INBIX conference, which is a very important event to bring all the bioinformaticians of this country and connect them to all the people who are well-wishers of BioClues nationally and internationally. This is the third conference in series. The first one in 2017 was in Jaipur, and I had the privilege of attending that. And the second one was in Jalandhar, and both these things are very, very big successes. And the current conference, the third one in the series, has provided a different platform, the online platform, for us to deliberate on various issues. And this particular conference has many, many eminent people as invited speakers, starting from Dr. Binay Panda, Debashish Mohanty, Sonika Tyagi, Ashwani Mishra, Abhishek Kumar, Ashish Anand, Pritish Varadwaj, Rajiv Bandopadhyaya, Sushmita Pal, Harsha Burri, Partha Sarathi Das, Harpreet Singh, Malik Yusuf, Girish T. Mohannath, and a few others. And in addition to these invited lectures, it also has oral presentations, and one important aspect is to have the video abstracts, poster talks, and tutorial and workshops are also being conducted. And one of the pre-conference workshop that is being conducted is for bioinformatics to systems genomics, from 1st of December to 3rd of December. And we also would like to invite you to panel discussions, ideation challenges, and so on and so forth. I would like to invite all of you on behalf of BioClues, which, as I said, Dr. Prashant and Dr. Pritish and many of their friends have come together in 2005 to initiate this organization. And before me, Dr. Jayaraman Valladi has led this organization as the president very effectively, and he continues to support the organization with all his nice ideas and mentorship and guiding us at every stage. And Dr. GPS Raghava was its president before Dr. Jayaraman Valladi. And currently we have a strong team. In addition to Dr. Prashant and Dr. Pritish, the secretary, Dr. Devendra Bishwal, who has just spoken before me, has been a pillar of support for running many of the programs involving BioClues in general and INBIX in particular. And we also have very strong joint secretaries in the name of Dr. Sugunakar and Dr. Santosh. And we have other joint secretaries, Dr. Himakshi and Dr. Nagamani. In financial chairs are Harpreet and Manoj Agarwal. And we also have women in biology chairs by Dr. Shakshi Singh and Dr. Aparna Banerjee. And bioinformatics for school children is being coordinated by Dr. Sujata Dhar and Dr. Renuka. Students chapter chairs are Hirak Jyoti Das and I.M. Gupta. And entrepreneurs chairs are being led by a very experienced Dr. V.S. Sundararajan and Dr. Sivaramaya Allapeta. And outreach chair are with Santaram Joshi and Tirthraj Singh. And research chair is Professor Jayaraman Valadi and Thikamchan Dakal. And mentoring chairs are Dr. Pritish Varadwaj and Dr. Hemant Srivastava. And I am very strongly supported by Dr. Devendra Bishwal as the secretary and the vice president, Dr. S.R. Joshi from Nehu. And we are all very lucky to have a continued mentorship and support from Dr. Jayaraman Valadi. I would like to take a few minutes to tell how this bioinformatics is evolving in our country. Sometime back, bioinformatics was considered as a field which is restricted to biology or people who are using the computational modeling approaches in on biological systems was considered as bioinformatics. But nowadays, bioinformatics, systems biology, and other modeling, informatics, data science approaches have played a very, very important role in diverse areas, right from biochemistry, molecular biology, pharmacology, drug discovery, agriculture, microbiology, so on and so forth. And especially in the times where knowledge generation is important, integration of approaches which involve simulation, modeling, and informatics played a very important role. Historically, India's contribution has been phenomenal in structural biology, led by great Dr. G. N. Ramachandran. Actually, Ramachandran's plot is one of the finest example in modern science or in recent past about how you can classify different structural motifs in the protein and try to give a pattern just based on data. And this model was so very effective, and we are able to get a very good understanding of how different secondary structural motifs organize themselves as a function of the phi and psi angles, the two dihedral angles that are there. And in addition to that, when drug discovery became very important, or vaccine discovery became very important, the number of experimental approaches which one has to undertake are so many, and it is very difficult to understand how a particular approach will be useful or successful or efficient. And computational modeling, molecular modeling, has played a very important role in understanding the mechanism of action of a particular drug by trying to find out what is the best fit of this small molecule to the receptor. After getting a reasonable understanding of optimizing the drug efficacy, which we call it as lead optimization, there are other factors like toxicity, pharmacokinetics, pharmacodynamics. And these factors also can be modeled very effectively by computational approaches. And when you have very, very fundamental problems in structural biology, they are beyond the experimental science to address why and how things are happening the way they are happening. It has become imperative for people to employ computational approaches. Very, very time-demanding simulations and multi-scale modeling approaches. And these things have played a very important role, and people have acknowledged their importance in generating the new knowledge. And when we are trying to have a more and more sophisticated experimental facilities to decipher the interactions between, whether it's a protein ligand interactions or drug receptor interactions, antigen antibody interaction or protein protein interactions, the computational approaches play a very important role. And in addition to that, people have realized that not only having models which will mimic the interactions at some level are important, but we also have to develop more robust and more rigorous algorithms, methods, which will be able to refine the confidence levels in our numbers. For example, if you try to look at a drug receptor interaction, you have a procedure called docking, and it will give, based on a scoring function, some number. What is the meaning of that number? Probably it will give you an indication that a particular small molecule will bind a little bit more effectively compared to another molecule. But the confidence levels are very low. We may have to go to a more rigorous level, like an MMPBSA or MMGBSA type of an approach. Or you may have to go to a free energy perturbation approach. Or you may have to go to approaches which are much more rigorous, which demand more computational power. So people also have challenges of devising more powerful algorithms, more powerful ways of parallelizing them. Or these are the methods which will give challenges for people to devise the hardware, whether it is GPUs or CPU based hardware, which will solve this problem. Parallelly, the usage of quantum mechanics, density functional theory, has become very high in addition to the conventional molecular dynamics, Monte Carlo and other simulation approaches. So there are also bigger challenges are how do we employ the more fundamental computational quantum mechanical approaches to larger biomolecules. All of them are one side of the coin. But currently, data science, machine learning, artificial intelligence, deep learning approaches have invaded every branch of science, engineering, and medicine. So, the role of people who are employing computational approaches, in silico approaches, has become highly prominent. You can never ever ignore the multifaceted problems that can be solved by computational approaches. So, conventionally we have the two paradigms, experiment and theory, and the third paradigm as modeling, and fourth paradigm as data science, and integrating this third and fourth paradigm and also putting them in line with the first and second paradigm has become very important. And I am very, very sure that the modern computational approaches will provide very effective solutions in generating new knowledge and new data, which will help us to discover drugs and vaccines, and more importantly, rationalize the results that are there, and also how the pandemic is evolving and it's spreading, and what are the ways in which you can develop solutions and I wanted this two-day conference of INBIX a grand success, and I thank all the people who have come to give talks and all the participants to get the benefit in the next 2 days. And I am just a person who happened to occupy this chair of this presidentship, but all the hard work is done by the workers led by Dr. Devendra, Dr. Prash, and Dr. Joshi, Dr. Jairam, Dr. Jairam, and many other people. And I wish you a very exciting 2 days. And as we progress in the next 2 days, your confidence in BioClues will increase. And I am particularly happy with the Bioinformatics for School Children concept, where people try to introduce bioinformatics at a very, very early stage. And I thank the organizers for doing a wonderful job, and I wish you all the very best. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.